welcome to Beyond the Trailer's coverage of the 2013 Academy Awards, giving you an in-depth look at the top categories. And be sure to cast your own vote for who you think should win in our poll at tinyurl.com/BTTOscarVote2013. There's even a write-in section. Now let's take a look at the nominees for Best Actress.
Jessica Chastain, Zero Dark Thirty.
Fascinatingly, Jessica Chastain is not the only redhead that the Academy has recently fallen in love with. Back in 2006, Amy Adams instantly rose to stardom with her nomination for Junebug, just as Chastain did last year with The Help. And like Adams, it looks like Chastain is going to become a fixture at the Oscars with her second nomination in just 2 years. However, Adams is yet to win, and with the tough competition in this category this year, it seems Chastain will also have to agree it's just nice to be nominated. Then there's the controversy over the accuracy of Zero Dark Thirty, which could further hurt her chances of winning. Not to mention that Claire Danes is already winning tons of awards for basically playing the same role. However, both did just win Golden Globes. But regardless of what happens on Oscar night, Chastain has some work to do, as while she and Adams are both Oscar darlings, Chastain has yet to crack mainstream Hollywood as Adams has.
Jennifer Lawrence, Silver Linings Playbook.
Like Chastain, this is Lawrence's second nomination after she burst onto the scene with Winter's Bone in 2011. But unlike Chastain and even Adams, Lawrence has become a genuine movie star, first in X-Men First Class where she took over the role of Mystique, and then of course this year is Katniss in The Hunger Games. That means the Academy has a decision to make. Do they punish Lawrence for pursuing box office dollars, something actors usually do after they win the gold, or reward her for not forgetting that she's an artist as well as a marquee name? The latter has been how her publicists have been promoting her, so the Academy could decide to play along and lay claim to one of Hollywood's hottest young stars. And any other year, Lawrence would probably be a frontrunner, but again, with the tough competition in this category, the Academy could ultimately decide that box office success is enough of a reward, at least this year.
Emmanuel Riva, Amour.
Normally, I'd say that being the oldest actress at 85 ever nominated for the Best Actress Oscar would make Riva a lock. The Academy has a long tradition of giving the Oscar to the oldest contender because, well, it could be their last chance. But as I've said, this is a tough category this year. Riva, though, is certainly a contender even beyond her age. Her role as a stroke victim slipping away from her husband screams Oscar and could touch a nerve with voters who have a median age of 62. Plus, actors are the largest voting bloc in the Academy, and they might be highly tempted to reward Riva's acting career of 50-plus years.
Quvenzhané Wallace, Beasts of the Southern Wild.
But how about an actress who's just starting her career? At 9 years old, Wallace is the youngest nominee for Best Actress, although a surprising number of kids have been nominated for Best Supporting Actress. But if you think that's impressive, Wallace was just 6 when she shot Beasts of the Southern Wild, a movie in which she not only stars, but for a large part of it commands the screen all on her own. And voters could indeed be eager to reward the debut of such an acting prodigy. However, Wallace is already currently filming her next film, 12 Years a Slave, for Steve McQueen. So one could imagine she'll be back here in the future, possibly the near future.
Naomi Watts, The Impossible.
While the other 4 actresses in this category might have to say it's just nice to be nominated, Naomi Watts can start saying it now. This is one of those situations where the nomination itself is a win, garnering some much-needed attention for this spectacular yet largely overlooked Spanish film. Plus, as everyone in the industry knows, Watts beat out Chastain for the coveted role of Princess Diana in the upcoming biopic, which will surely give her a much stronger shot at winning the gold than her work here in The Impossible. And now that she's got 2 nominations to her name, she was a contender back in 2004 for 21 Grams, Watts can simply enjoy the ceremony, knowing that her future Diana bid is not only made that much stronger, but that after a serious string of flops, her career has already been re-energized. And those are the 2013 Best Actress nominees. Who do you think deserves the Oscar? Leave your comments down below, and don't forget to vote in the Beyond the Trailer Oscar poll. It closes on February 12th. I'm Grace Randolph, and I hope you'll check out the rest of BTT's Oscar coverage.